You got millions of working families of America are now in debt to the few thousand banking families that are living the American dream. The American people are in debt to their banking families. The banking families run the entire United States. And these banking families obtain that debt against us for the cost of paper, ink, and bookkeeping. That's it. They're giving you nothing of value. Peace, Patrice. Long time no see, sis. The interest amount is never created. So the only way new money, which is not true money, but is created representing a debt, goes into circulation is America. In America is when it is borrowed from the bankers. When the state and the people borrow large sums, we seem to prosper, right? But the bankers create only the amount of the principal on each loan, never the extra money needed to pay the interest. So therefore, the new money never equals the new debt added. The amounts needed to pay the interest on the loan is not created, and therefore does not exist. Under this kind of system, brothers and sisters, money never equals the new debt. The amount needed to pay the interest on the loans is not created, and therefore does not exist. You know what I told you? See, under this kind of system, where the new debt always exceeds the new money, no matter how much or how little is borrowed, the total debt increasingly outstrips the amount of money available to pay the debt. The people can never, ever get out of debt. Become a secure party creditor and discharge that shit. That's your only way, man. I'm telling you. And you think I'm crazy. And if you do, you're going to be in debt for the rest of your damn life. Discharge that shit, man. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. Pardon my French. Let me show you some viciousness of this usury debt system with its built-in shortage of money. Watch this. Watch this. So let's say 60,000 is borrowed. 255,931.20 must be paid back. You know what I told you? If you borrow 60,000, at minimum, you're going to have to pay back $255,931.20. See, when a citizen goes to a banker to borrow $60,000 to purchase a home or a farm, and this is a small, old-school home, right? You can push that up now to $200,000-some. You can pay back $1 million, buddy. You know what I told you? I want you to think. You go and borrow $60,000 to purchase a home or a farm. The bank clerk has the borrower agreed to pay back the loan plus interest at 14% for 30 years. The borrower must agree to pay $710 per month for a total of $255,931.20. Now, if your loan is more than that, multiply that times 30. At whatever interest rate they told you to, you got to pay it back at, that's how much you're paying, man, for 30 years. So then the clerk requires the citizen to assign to the bank the right of ownership of the property. You just signed your damn home away right there. This is why I tell you to become a secure party creditor, man. Bill of exchange not going to get you out of it, man. Consumer credit's not going to get you out of it. You become a damn creditor, secure creditor, put a lien against it, man, and protect your assets. What are you waiting for? So, yeah, a car too, Dora. A car too. Come on. So the clerk requires the citizen to assign to the bank the right of ownership of the property if the borrower does not make the required payment. You don't reserve your rights. You don't get Kahan Tazadaq's book and learn how to properly reserve your rights or amend the contract. You're just going like a straight up debtor, straight up 14th Amendment citizen. Well, the bank clerk then gives the borrower $60,000 check or a $60,000 deposit slip, crediting the borrower's checking account with $60,000. The borrower then writes the check to the builder or the subcontractor, whatever, right? Who in turn writes a check to $60,000 of a new checkbook. The money's thereby added to the money in circulation. But this is the fatal flaw in a usury system. The only new money created and put into circulation is the amount of the loan, $60,000. The money to pay the interest is not created and therefore was not added to the money in circulation. So even so, the borrower and those who follow him in ownership of the property must earn and take out of circulation $255,931, almost $200,000 more than what he put into circulation when he borrowed the original $60,000. Now, you tell me that's not a screwed up damn system. It's the kind of system we're dealing with, folks. And you wonder why the foul mouth Kahan told you to discharge it? And by the way, it is this entrance which cheats the families out of their homes. It is not that you can't afford your home, man. It's the entrance that they added. It wouldn't take you 30 years to pay that home off without entrance. They're cheating you with the usury. This is why I went into the scriptures when I first started this thing, man. It's not that you can't afford it. It's because the banker's usury forces you to pay four times the amount the home is worth to get one. You know what I told you, Gully the Kid? Every new loan puts the same process into operation. Each borrower adds a small sum to the total money supply when he borrows. But the payments on the loan, because of the entrance, then deduct a much larger sum from the total money supply. That creates the deficit, Matthew. You know what I told you? There's therefore no way for old debtors can pay off money lenders. I don't give a damn if they're telling you to do a bill of exchange, consumer credit. Negro, you're still in debt. You got to become a creditor to get out of this. You got to become a secure creditor. Because why? As you pay the principal and the interest, the money in circulation disappears. And they could do is struggle against each other, borrowing more and more and more from the money lenders each generation. See, the money lenders, which are the bankers, right, who produce nothing of value, slowly, then more rapidly gain a death grip on the land, on the buildings, and the present and future earnings of the whole working population. You're not but a damn debtor slave. And that's what slavery really is. Proverbs 22:7. Proverbs 22:7 has to come to pass in America, man. You know what I told you, Matthew? You're biblical, man. The borrower has become the servant to the lenders. Without the use of visible force or coercion, so that the victims do not realize that they've been conquered, such it is today. Tribute is collected from them in the form of legal debts and taxes.